Evening. My name is Colleen Medeiros. I'm the Transportation Program Manager here at the Cape Cod Commission. We're excited here to talk to you tonight about the Cape Cod Regional Transportation Plan, and more importantly, hear your feedback as this regional plan is developed. We would look forward to hearing some feedback. And tonight we also have David Nolan here on staff, Senior Transportation Planner, who'll be presenting. We also have Evan Costa and Stephen Tupper on our staff as well. Just a few quick announcements. This meeting is just being recorded and will be available on the Cape Cod Commission Regional Transportation webpage later this week for later viewing. And if anyone's having technical issues tonight, you may use the chat box on your screen or use this phone number to and staff will assist you. And then again, participants wishing to speak later on in the session, we can use the raise hand toolbar to let us know you would like to speak. And if you're on the phone, that is *9 to raise your hand and *6 to unmute yourself. Okay. Just a general quick meeting agenda overview. We are going to go just over the regional transportation plan. What is it and what does it encompass, as well as the development schedule for the RTP. Then we'll go into some existing conditions review, as well as our RTP draft vision and goals that we've developed, and the online survey and mapping tool, which is available now, and we are available to get feedback as part of the development of the RTP, and then we'll end with some questions. So just a quick overview, if you're not familiar, the Cape Cod Commission is the Regional Land Use Planning and Economic Development and Regulatory Agency for the 15 towns on Bartlesville County in Massachusetts. Our mission is to protect the unique values and quality of life on Cape Cod by courting a balanced relationship between environmental protection and economic progress. One of the ways the Cape Cod Commission staff is we lead preparation of many different regional plans. The first being the Cape Cod Regional Policy Plan. That's the overarching plan that guides our policies and planning activities here in the Cape Cod. And then you'll see on this page several other regional plans that are developed by Cape Cod Commission staff. The Cape Cod Climate Action Plan was developed several years ago. And then right now we have underway a regional housing strategy, as well as the Cape Cod Freshwater Initiative and the Regional Transportation Plan. So what is the Regional Transportation Plan? This is the long-range transportation plan and vision document for Cape Cod in the next 20 to 25 years. So we'll be going out to 2050 with our expected funding timelines. It's a vision for all modes, so not just roads and cars, but we're also looking at pedestrians and bicyclists and our bike paths to ferries and transit vehicles as well, seeing how they all tie together and how people can get in and around our region. With the regional plan, transportation plan prioritizes infrastructure projects and programs within the available funding over the next 25 years. That will receive federal dollars. It was last updated in 2019, so it's called the 2020 RTP. And now we are updating it, and it'll be called the 2024 RTP. The document is prepared by commission staff on behalf of the Cape Cod Metropolitan Planning Organization. And what is the Cape Cod Metropolitan Planning Organization? They are the overseeing committee, the body that oversees all the federal dollars that for transportation funding that comes to the region. There are voting members that consist of Massachusetts Department of Transportation, a Bartlesville County Commissioner, a Cape Cod Commission board member, a member from the Cape Cod Regional Transit Authority, representative from the Mashpee Wampanoag Tribe, as well as community representatives shown on this map from these subregions. There's 5 subregions, and they are select board members from each of these areas, including the town of Bartlesville. It just has a seat for one town councilor member. And this, these seats are based on population demographics. And as well as there are non-voting members that participate through the Cape Cod Metropolitan Planning Organization, as you see on the slide, as well as the Cape Cod Joint Transportation Committee, which is an advisory committee to the MPO. And that is represented by the DPW directors and town engineers from each of the Cape Cod 15 towns. And they've been a part of this process for development of the RTP, providing a subcommittee for us as we develop some of these draft items we'll be presenting to you tonight. And again, the MPO will be potentially approving the RTP through this process. And it's being developed in conjunction with the MPO. And extensive stakeholder and public input is sought throughout this process. So we are not developing this document in a vacuum. We want to hear what the users and residents and visitors and employees all need to make this region better in the next 25 years. So here's the schedule of the development of the RTP. It began last summer. We started to look at where we were, what needs were going forward, and collaborating with the state. They are also updating their long-range transportation plan. We are right now in the winter months. We are holding listening sessions. We have an online public survey. We have continued development discussions this spring with the Cape Cod MPO during their monthly meetings. Those meetings are held virtually once a month online, and they are open to the public. With that, we are targeting a draft document for the RTP to be released for public comment in May at their meeting. Now we'll go for a 21-day public comment period. And along with some additional meetings, we'll be holding for public outreach opportunities for feedback with the goal of a potential approval of the RTP in the June timeframe. So as I mentioned, the RTP is looking at the transportation network on Cape Cod as a whole. Again, we are looking at the roadways, the bicycle pedestrian network, where are public transportation stops and services, as well as our airport connections, ferry opportunities and connections, as well as our rail service as well, how they all come together. And I'm actually gonna go through that little broad overview to give you a sense of what we have here on Cape Cod. And from a terms of miles of roadway, we have 3,700 miles of roadway here on Cape Cod. Majority of them is owned locally by the towns, 77%. We do have a portion that is owned by the state, Mass DOT. And think of that as those are our two main, you know, major spine roadways, Route 28, Route 6 Mid-Cape Highway, and Route 6 Outer Cape. Those are some of the main regional roadway connectors. In terms of intersections, we have a count of 160 intersections, majority being signalized. Moving on to bridges, we have an inventory of bridges here in Cape Cod. There's approximately 102. Their majority split is over roadway, but you know, being surrounded by water, a lot of them are also over the water. We do have some over rail as well. Airports and airfields, there are 6 total here on Cape Cod. 3 are general aviation. We have Barnstable and Provincetown and Chatham. And then we have the scheduled carrier service out of those two main ones in Provincetown and Barnstable, as well as the military base in Bourne. Moving on to paved multi-use paths. So we have 106 miles of paved multi-use paths here on Cape Cod. So you'll think the Cape Cod Regional, Cape Cod Rail Trail, Colony Trail, Rail Trail. We also have a majority out on the National Seashore as well. And then other as well, but there's a lot of other towns that are moving forward with sections of path, which is great to see moving forward. The other set piece of that is sidewalks. So again, I stated earlier, we have approximately 3,700 miles of roadway. Only 277 miles of that has a sidewalk. And that's concerning. You know, we need to make sure people can be able to walk around and connect for recreational, but also just to get around safely to points of employment, to transit service. Majority of the sidewalk that is on these roads is only on one side. So that's somewhere what we're concerning and would like to see move forward, is making sure our roads are safe for all users. Speaking of transit service, Cape Cod Regional Transit Authority provides service here on Cape Cod through the towns with 7 year-round routes. There are 3 seasonal routes as well. We have those in Falmouth, Provincetown, and Hyannis, and those are very popular and seasonal routes. The RTA also provides a dial-a-ride service as well, and a Cape Flyer service, which is a passenger rail service in the summer months on the weekend, so Friday to Sunday. And that's been a great asset here to get people to Cape Cod without a car. So there is, thanks for the collaboration with the RTA, we are seeing opportunities for people to get in and around Cape Cod without using their vehicle. Additionally, because we're surrounded by water, we have ferry options as well. So there are 9 ferry routes. Majority are to the islands of Martha's Vineyard and Nantucket, but you also can get to Cape Cod from Boston and Plymouth, actually. So with connections via Provincetown. And as well as majority of those are ferry routes are in Falmouth and Hyannis, but also there is one in Harwichport, if you're not aware, Saugatuck Harbor. Lastly, moving on to rail. So we have approximately 54 miles of rail track here on Cape Cod. And the majority is on the Cape Cod line, which goes over the railroad bridge and into Barnstable, basically along the bay side of in Sandwich into Barnstable and Yarmouth, with a few other miles of railway. The majority of rail today is mainly to provide freight service for hauling trash off Cape Cod. We do have the occasional scenic dinner trains, as well as I mentioned, passenger commuter rail in the summer months via the Cape Flyer. And with that, there are actually 102 railroad crossings. The majority are at grade crossings. So, but last time with the RTP 4 years ago, this was the funding breakdown. We currently are still gathering the information of what we have for funding over the next 25 years. As you see here, there's approximately $1.1 billion that was allocated to the region. And there's a breakdown of where that dollars were spent. So the federal dollars come and they can be spent on transit projects or highway or roadway projects. And the highway roadway projects can include items such as bridges and bike paths and sidewalk projects. And there's 2 different ways to allocate the dollars, whether it's regional target dollars or statewide dollars that are spent down here in Cape Cod. And then you see on the right, the distribution of spending that $1.1 billion. So this was developed last time around with, you know, based on public feedback in coordination with the MPO as an advisory board to the JTC, and we had a subcommittee as well, as where those dollars should be spent in terms of categories of priorities. So as you'll see here, we'll be talking a lot about this tonight: safety projects, reducing congestion, maintaining roads and bridges, bicycle and pedestrian improvements, and transit. You'll see smaller categories last time around was on climate change, mitigation, and technology. And those things are that we're taking review right now and looking for feedback on. You know, things have changed in the last 4 years. The commission has developed a climate action plan grant. So we've identified potential new projects that might be worthwhile to be funding for the future. And so those percentages are likely to change with the new RTP. And for the overall of the RTP, this is going to be a document we're underway developing. So the way it develops is we have this vision statement and the overarching vision of the plan. And it'll be guiding the set of goals that we've developed. And it's approximately 7 areas of emphasis right now. And under each goal, there's a set of objectives. So these are the focused elements that we want to focus on. And with those objectives, then we'll be tracking with them with performance measures, as well as strategies and policies. that'll help us detail an approach to meet these performance measures. So this is the overall outline of that we're following for the development of the RTP. And now the last slide here is, what will transportation look like in 2050? So that's what we're asking ourselves and we're asking for everyone around is, you know, taken into consideration what it might look like. And you'll see here, this is a photo of Provincetown and the roadways underwater. So there's definitely things such as changing population and demographics and land use. Last time we updated the RTP was 2019, pre-pandemic. So a lot has changed. So we've seen a lot of shifts since that time. A lot more has been studied on climate change and low-lying roads. As well as we know, technology shifts and evolving, that's constantly evolving. So we're trying to predict, you know, that electric vehicles are more prevalent now and will continue to be. Things such as ride sharing, as well as last time, we have more Uber and Lyft opportunities down here, as well as the Regional Transit Agency has developed a Smart Dart, which is their own ride service, ride sharing opportunity as well. Autonomous vehicles as well. We don't know much about it now, but know that it's coming. And it could be a possibility by 2050, as well as other opportunities. And the biggest challenge is the funding. So there are many, many problems and issues, but how do we get enough funding to solve these challenges and prioritize which challenges and projects receive the funding? So now I'm gonna hand it over to David Nolan, Senior Transportation Planner, who will go over some of the items on the draft 2024 RTP, including our draft vision statement.
Thank you, Colleen, and good evening, everyone. I'm Dave Nolan, the Senior Transportation Planner at the Cape Cod Commission. And Colleen showed a slide a couple moments ago that kind of outlined the RTP and the vision statement, the goals and the objectives. So I'm going to talk about that vision statement and the goals and the objectives over the next couple of slides. So firstly, I wanted to share with the you all the draft vision statement. So right now, our draft vision statement states, the Cape Cod Metropolitan Planning Organization, informed by public input, envisions a multimodal transportation system that supports the environmental and economic vitality of the region through infrastructure investment that focuses on safety, livability, sustainability, resiliency, equity, and preservation of the character that makes our special place special. So we have seven goals with the underlying objectives as part of the 2024 RTP at this point. Those include safety, environmental and sustainability, multimodal options and healthy transportation, livability and economic vitality, congestion reduction, system preservation, and freight mobility. And a lot of those things are hit on in the mission statement or the vision statement I previously shared. So goal one is safety. Simply put, the idea is to improve safety for all modes. So in the box here, those are those objectives that are under the goal. Some of our objectives are to reduce the number and severity of crashes associated with all modes, eliminate serious injuries and fatalities associated with all modes, and apply a safe systems approach to investment decisions, including a focus on safe speeds. So the safe systems approach is a newer way of thinking. It's more preventative. It's less reactionary based. I think previously we look at a lot of our highest crash locations and then react after crashes and fatalities have occurred. We're trying to get ahead of that. That's sort of the new way of thinking. So building safer roads for all roadway users, you know, making sure there's sidewalks or paths, appropriate crossings where needed, not just planning for roadway vehicles anymore, but for all users. Safer vehicles technology is expanding rapidly. So making sure that vehicle safety is still continuing to improve. Safer speeds, if we can slow vehicles down when crashes do occur, it reduces the chance of fatalities or serious injuries. So getting vehicles to travel more safely. Safer roads, of course, building roadways that are safer. And then a sort of new concept is post-crash care. So of course a crash occurs and then that's when emergency response comes into play. You know, assisting a motorist or maybe even a bike or pedestrian that was hit, and, you know, hopefully getting them to a state where they're going to be okay. That response time, making sure the whole system operates more safely from, you know, from planning level and engineering to through construction while it's built, and then if an incident were to occur, improving that post-crash care. The second goal is environmental and resiliency. This is to maintain, protect, and enhance the natural environment and reduce greenhouse gas emissions. Some of the objectives under this goal are to minimize the negative impacts of the transportation system on the natural environment, reduce greenhouse gas emissions in support of the statewide net zero carbon target set for 2050, accelerate the electrification of the transportation system, improve stormwater management and treatment to improve impaired fresh and marine water resources, and to improve resiliency of the transportation system to address critical low-lying roads and design infrastructure to meet the challenges of our changing climate. An example of some climate tasks that the commission's been working on in recent years is a low-lying roads project. The commission has worked with all 15 towns on the Cape to examine the vulnerabilities in the roadway network and identify adaptation alternatives. Essentially, the commission's been working with the municipalities to identify those areas of critical concern. The idea is to identify two prioritized roadway segments for some of those adaptation alternatives. That may be replacing or improving a failing culvert. It could be more of an environmental project where it might be restoring or repairing some dunes. And in some cases, it could just be letting a road go, letting it flood and sort of closing that roadway off and finding new ways for all travel modes to get around that area. Goal three is livability and economic vitality. This is to support livable communities and village centers that strengthen the long-term economic vitality of the region. Some of the objectives included in this are supporting mixed-use development in compact centers of activity, improving connections between housing, jobs, cultural centers, and essential services within and beyond the region, developing a transportation system that is consistent with the local character of the region and the residents and visitors, and then supporting land use strategies and investments in the roadway network that encourage walkability, public transit, and promoting appropriate connections to housing. An example of some projects that have been undertaken recent years through the commission is the Complete Streets Initiative. Complete Streets is a Mass DOT funded program, and the commission has helped several towns in the Cape so far with prioritization plans. Complete Streets are essentially roadways that are designed for all roadway users. So we've been assisting some of the towns you see noted here on the screen: Eastham, Orleans, Falmouth, Bourne, and Barnstable. We've been helping them with prioritization plans. Towns are eligible for up to $500,000 in construction funding for potential projects. The town of Sandwich has received funding twice through this program, and the town of Eastham actually was awarded $500,000 just this fall for a project on Samoset Road that would include a multi-use path getting you from the existing Cape Cod Rail Trail to the intersection of Route 6 in Eastham on Samoset Road. Goal four is multimodal and healthy transportation. This is to provide a variety of healthy transportation options to all users. So some of those objectives include improving accessibility of all modes to all users, applying those Complete Streets principles to all projects, expanding and closing gaps in the bicycle and sidewalk network, improving coordination between all modes, and increasing the share of travel by means other than a single occupancy vehicle. Some work I wanted to highlight under this task is our bike path network, or what we're calling Vision 88. This graphic here shows you our rail trail spine here in the region. So that blue color you see on the map, those are our existing bike paths. You see the Shining Sea Bikeway down in Falmouth into Woods Hole. There's the canal access road on the south side of the canal there, in Bourne and Sandwich. Then you have the Cape Cod Rail Trail starting in Yarmouth, traveling through Wellfleet. And then the green lines on the map here are the funded or under construction bike paths. There's a small little spur in Bourne coming south from the canal access path. That's funded in the next couple of years for construction. The Green Line in Sandwich, this is currently under construction. That is a shared use path along Service Road. If you're driving on Route 6, you'll see that construction underway currently. The green spur there in Barnstable in Yarmouth, that's actually going to connect the existing Cape Cod Rail Trail network from its terminus in Yarmouth to Mary Dunn Road in Barnstable. So that will get Barnstable as a town along the Cape Cod Rail Trail network. And then the orange lines here are potential bike paths that are in planning at this point, planning stage. There's no funding associated with them. But those paths that you see in Bourne, Sandwich, Barnstable, and then the Outer Cape towns, those all help form the Vision 88. 88 referring to 88 miles of continuous off-road bike path from Woods Hole to Provincetown. So this is our overall goal for a complete bike path network in our region. Goal 5 is congestion reduction, reducing congestion to improve travel time reliability. The objectives under this are to reduce delay for all modes, address congestion at bottleneck locations, improve connectivity and reliability for all modes of transportation, and minimizing the impacts of construction delays on all users, particularly impacts of the Cape Cod Rail, Cape Cod Canal bridge repair, maintenance, and construction activities. Obviously, that's a very timely one right now with the ongoing repair work being done at the Sagamore Bridge. Obviously, there's some challenges with the congestion and the bottleneck at the points of entry to the Cape, the Bourne and Sagamore bridges. I'll highlight a study that was completed a couple years ago, which was a bottleneck study at the Mashpee Rotary along Route 28 and Route 151. So that graphic on the left sort of shows the PM peak queue lengths that sort of boiled into, we know that this is a real pinch point along a major regional roadway, Route 28. In our region, the commission undertook a study, a corridor planning study of Mashpee Rotary. And now there is a project that is in the works to actually improve the congestion, upgrade safety, and provide multimodal accommodations at the Mashpee Rotary. And that's what that graphic on the right shows. So you'll see that there's better lane assignment to help more vehicles get through this congested intersection. Those orange lines that you see around the rotary there are actually bike and pedestrian accommodations. So sidewalks or multi-use paths, providing crossings, safe crossings along the rotary as well. So improving this entire area to not only reduce congestion, but to improve safety for all modes. Goal 6 is system preservation. This is to preserve, maintain, modernize, and ensure resiliency of the existing transportation system. Some of the objectives under this goal are to improve the condition of all bridges, improve the pavement condition on all federal aid eligible roadways, maintain and improve on and off-road bicycle and pedestrian facilities, use modern technology to improve transportation efficiency, and improve coordination and cooperation between agencies throughout all phases of project development and implementation for all improvement and maintenance projects. Two examples of some system preservation projects that are ongoing in our region. Currently under construction is Route 151 in Mashpee. That's that photo in the bottom right corner there. So Route 151 in Mashpee is being repaved. The multi-use path along the roadway is also being repaved and extended to the town line of Falmouth. Another major regional corridor in our system that was definitely needing of some upgrades. So preserving that roadway for the long haul. On the left is a graphic of the future Bass River Bridge. This is for the towns of Yarmouth and Dennis along Route 28. Currently the Bass River Bridge on 28 is structurally deficient. And in the next couple of years, you'll be seeing construction of a new bridge to replace the existing one. And again, we're not just building for vehicles anymore. You can see the shared use path on the bridge there. There's some lookouts for folks to be able to pull off and actually enjoy some of the scenic views that we have here on the Cape. Again, trying to keep this special place that we have special while accommodating all of our roadway users. And then the last goal we have as part of the draft RTP here is freight mobility. This is to improve efficiency and reliability of the freight movement. So reducing delays of the freight network, improving travel time reliability on the freight network, minimizing the impacts of the canal bridge repair, maintenance, and construction activities, and utilizing the most efficient freight modes and technologies to minimize impacts on the community and the environment. You see a couple of things that sort of get hit on here, both in the system preservation as well as the congestion reduction objectives. So highlighting some freight corridors, this is a photo that was taken last time the Sagamore Bridge was undergoing maintenance repairs and was down to one travel lane in each direction. Obviously, it's the major corridor in our region, Route 6, getting not only freight, but all traffic to and off the Cape. On the right here is a photo from Route 134 in Dennis. If you're familiar with that area, you know that that roadway is always populated with larger vehicles, construction vehicles, freight, and so on. A very congested corridor as well that the commission has actually put some of our planning work into over recent years. So this is a list of potential future projects. Again, projects that we want to receive funding someday need to be included in the RTP. You won't see in the RTP maybe the local intersection projects. If you're thinking of that signal near your house that you want to be included in this project, what we're trying to do is really encompass everything in this plan. So you noted some things, the canal, Cape Cod Canal area and bridges. Of course, that's one of the biggest ongoing hot topic projects in our region. Including that in this plan seems to make the most sense. But Route 28 reconstruction and multimodal improvements, that's fairly all encompassing for all the towns along the Route 28 corridor in our region. There's many challenges on Route 28 from safety to lacking the multimodal accommodations. Of course, there's our regional transit authority routes along Route 28. Route 6 Outer Cape multimodal improvements. Again, think bike pedestrian, think transit service. It's sort of an all-encompassing project. So that way projects along this corridor can receive, are eligible to receive funding over the next 25 years. Route 6 Mid-Cape Highway interchange improvements. Commission staff has spent lots of time analyzing the limited access portion of Route 6 as well, looking at the length of our acceleration and deceleration lanes. In upcoming years, we're going to be looking at the intersection of the ramps at the local roadway level as well. So again, all encompassing here to make sure that all these projects can be considered for funding over the course of the next couple of years. Rotary retrofits, that's sort of, if you remember the Mashpee rotary graphic I showed a couple of minutes ago, taking our older, more outdated rotaries in our region and sort of retrofitting them with modern roundabout elements to improve safety and congestion. Cape Cod Rail Trail extensions, again, there's our Vision 88 map. We want to make sure we can get funding to complete this network so that way we can all go out and enjoy the Cape Cod Rail Trail network and go for the ride from Woods Hole to Provincetown. Cape Cod Regional Transit Authority, a couple projects that we wanted to include here, bus electrification. Of course, this is going to help improve a lot of the climate issues in our region. I think the transportation network is moving quickly to electrification. The Regional Transit Authority is currently working on upgrading their fleet to all electric vehicles as well. Expansion of the Cape Cod Regional Transit bus service, that could be along that Route 28 corridor. That could be along the Route 6 corridor as well. This could be providing more buses, more frequent service, more days of the week, and so on. And then lastly, providing future passenger rail service or year-round rail service to our region. Obviously, the Cape Cod Regional Transit Authority works with the MBTA to get the Cape Flyer to our region during the summer months on the weekends. We would love to have a more frequent year-round passenger rail service to and from our region to better connect us to the rest of the state. So this is a slide that shows sort of the outreach schedule. Last night we were in Truro presenting on this topic. We were at the Hyannis Transportation Center earlier today. Obviously, we're here tonight presenting virtually. In April, we'll be in Sandwich doing the same presentation with a more focused look at bicycle and pedestrian aspects of the plan. And then there'll be a second round of meetings to coincide with the release of the document in June. So I'll give it back to Colleen now, but I think we're going to pause here for any questions or discussion. And then we're going to show off our online survey and mapping tool.
Thank you, Dave. And thank you all for attending. We're just going to take this opportunity to take a pause. I know we've been talking a lot, and if there's any clarifying questions or discussion points. So we have an online survey that we'd like to give you an overview of. There's two components to it, you know, question-based and then a mapping opportunity as well. So hopefully that will give you opportunity to provide feedback. So we will be going over that as well. But happy to hear, you know, we presented some potential projects, but again, that's not a comprehensive list. There's, you know, definitely more under consideration. That was just a quick snapshot, but curious to hear, and you know, this online survey, we hope to get great support back to really garner where people's thoughts are on what is the need in the region and where these funding dollars should be spent to. Do a lot of people want to see more EV chargers in the region, or do we just still want to focus on fixing what we have for roads? So there's a broad range. So we're happy to take any questions at this point, and then we can move on and give you guys a demo of the online mapping survey and question tool. And there's another opportunity for discussion point at that time. So I'll just take a quick pause. If anyone would like to raise their hand, feel free to. Stephen Buckley.
Yes, Stephen Buckley from Chatham. I was looking at your goals there, and I'm wondering, is there any goal that, and I would think that some of them are can conflict with each other, but I was wondering if there was, if you all thought they might be in conflict. And I'll give an example. If you could get your transportation engineer's wish and make all the congestion go away, it certainly would be more attractive for people to come to Cape Cod, but then it might not be as special if a whole lot of people, if it was a lot easier for people to come to Cape Cod and drive around on Cape Cod. Isn't there a point at which, geez, there's too many people driving around now or just coming here and buying houses and second homes and so forth. So is there anything in the existing plan that speaks to that potential or what I would think might be a conflict?
No, I think you hit it right on the nose. You know, definitely need to, it's all about balance here within Cape Cod Commission in our plans. You know, we need to accommodate the future of the roads and projects, but under that goal 5 for congestion reduction, we do, our objective is to address congestion at the bottleneck location. So we're not looking to address congestion everywhere. We don't want to build every road and intersection for July traffic. We want to analyze where our regional bottlenecks are. And so that is, you know, Cape Cod Canal bridges. We're seeing some of the major rotary intersections as well. So that's where we want to focus as our strong standpoint. We do not want to necessarily increase traffic at every intersection and build 3 lanes everywhere. So that's kind of our focused effort there. And we put that as bottleneck locations.
But I guess the major bottleneck, as you just mentioned, well, I assume everybody understands that the biggest bottleneck as far as congestion goes is the canal bridges.
Yeah.
And so if that, and I noticed that was on the top of the list of projects and things and so forth, that if that is done before other things are done, or even if other things, everything was magically done at the same time. The major impediment, I guess, or obstacle to a lot of people who would come to Cape Cod is the fact that if you got rid of July traffic congestion at the bridges, then a lot of people, more people would come over the bridges. And even if everything was perfect and it was all safe and everything else, fact is that environmentally, these people are having to go to the bathroom someplace. So there will be, you know, that type of environmental impact from waste, having to deal with wastewater and other infrastructure problems. But I'm wondering, so does the existing plan talk to that, or is that more of, was that fall under the climate plan, the regional climate plan? Is that the term, Colleen?
Well, we have the climate action plan, so that's a separate document. But for speaking about the canal bridges, I believe this, you know, the state is not looking to increase the capacity of the bridges. So we're not necessarily addressing, the congestion is not necessarily just going to disappear with these locations, unfortunately. And it's more of a, maybe we shouldn't use the word address, maybe it should say balance. So it's trying to strike that balance of accommodating congestion in a reasonable way to reduce greenhouse gas emissions, improve safety. More congestion causes more accidents. Generally, you see rear ends when you're with traffic. So it's striking that balance. And I believe, you know, the Cape Cod Canal and the state is looking towards, you know, designing the Cape Cod Canal bridges in a way of, not increasing the number of travel lanes and capacity, but addressing some more of the safety issues and striking that balance of an opportunity to reduce congestion with providing, you know, new safety issues such as increased acceleration and deceleration lanes.
Well, I know that's the roundabout way of saying we're not intending to create more people to come to Cape Cod, but the fact that my personal opinion is that, and I'm an engineer too, but the idea that you widen a travel way, then I guess somebody would have to show me the evidence that more people won't come, whether you call it deceleration lanes or this or that. It's going to be easier and wider. And if you get rid of congestion, it's just going to be that you're increasing flow. Simple as that. So anyway, thank you. I'll let somebody else speak. Thank you very much.
Thank you. And you know, Steve, Stephen, to definitely stay in tune with the MassDOT project, the Canal Bridge project is ongoing. And I know you are well aware of the meetings going on. So definitely stay involved through that standpoint as well.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I've been going since 2014.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Long, we're getting there.
Okay.
Anyone else have any clarifying questions? You're welcome to chime in or comments. And if not, there's definitely more time still to, we also can go over a demonstration of our online survey, which may strike some ideas and inspire some ideas and potential feedback for us, so we can go into the online mapping and survey tool if there's not any, I don't see any raised hands this time. So I'll have Dave, Dave's gonna open up we are sending out information. There is an online public survey, and Dave, are you gonna?
Yeah, can you see my screen, yes. Colleen?
Yes.
Yeah, so I'm going to just sort of show obviously we're hosting these meetings and happy to take public comment during the meetings, but obviously we want to reach a broader audience as well. And even those in the meeting, if you want to spend more time to think about your thoughts and provide comments at a later point, you can do that. Here is the homepage for the RTP on the commission's website. On the right here, it shows you the upcoming meetings if you want to just be able to keep tabs on what's upcoming for this project. But right here at the top, you'll see the RTP survey, which is now open. There is a tab right here to click the survey. Right under that, there's also a link to our online mapping tool. I have these pulled up already. So once you click on the survey, it brings you to this screen here. where it offers you a little background on what the RTP is and the purpose of this survey. And then we have it offered in both English and Portuguese for those that need it. So first thing that we're looking for feedback on is the vision statement and the goals. There's an sort of an open-ended box right here. We can provide sort of any comments you'd like. If there's anything that you feel is missing, things that you would word differently. I think I've lost screen share privileges.
My apologies, I was staging for the end. You can just go in over that, Dave. My apologies.
Nope, no worries. All right, are we back? All right, perfect. So like I was saying, vision statement and goals, you can offer any feedback. We have the vision statement right here and all those goals listed. Continuing through, trying to better understand those that are taking the survey and those that are using our transportation network. So, you know, where do you live? Where do you typically work or go to school? We offer, you know, off Cape, the islands, and then all Cape communities, even other. It's not required that you fill out every single question as part of the survey either. So if there's ones that you don't feel comfortable filling out for whatever reason, you do not have to do that. Or if you're just more focused in some of these later ones, which I'll get to, you can certainly skip ahead and do that as well. Obviously, things changed a couple years ago with the pandemic. So a lot more folks are working in a hybrid mode. So we're trying to better understand how many days a week are you, you know, working or going to school in person versus being home. What other aspects of your life have changed sort of in the last couple of years? Uber and Lyft, you know, the ride share options have taken off. Changes in housing, have you moved, lost housing, relocated? Telemedicine, of course, we can do appointments now virtually rather than always going to the doctor's office. So some of these newer ways, things that we want to sort of understand what's going on in our region. Besides home or working, school trips, where are you spending most of your time? Same options as previous. And then trying to understand how folks travel. How many trips a week are you driving, walking, taking the bus, ride shares, and so on. We've got plenty of options here for folks to choose from. Then we get into a little bit more of those projects we discussed earlier. Here's where you can actually provide feedback on your support or opposition to some of these projects that were stated. You don't necessarily need to pick, you can pick the projects that you feel most passionate about one way or the other. These are just radio buttons. All you need to do is click it. It'll populate there. You can choose the same answers as well. You don't need to, you can strongly support all of them. You could strongly oppose all of them if you wanted to. You don't need to necessarily rank them in any order. Show some more again, you know, same projects I kind of walked through a couple slides ago are all included in here. Then we have some more transit specific projects. Obviously we have a lot of funding associated with transit in our region. So same type of thing. We put some high level potential projects in here, expansion of bus service, increased frequency, same thing, clicking these buttons, whether you strongly support or feel strongly against, however you want to take this, you can. Then what we do is at the bottom, because you know, clicking a button, you can't really offer too much other feedback with that. We have an all-encompassing sort of text box here where you can actually fill in something here. If maybe there's projects that you feel are missing, maybe there's projects on here you think should not be on here. If you have clarifying questions or whatever it might be, other ideas, other ways of thinking, this is where we want to hear that as well. Then this is some budgeting questions. So this is obviously we know funding is limited. So we want to understand we folks, I guess, level of support for these following categories. So 1 through 5 stars, 1 obviously being the least amount of support, 5 being the most. If safety is of the utmost importance to you, I would recommend choosing 5. If it's not, probably a 1. Roadway projects that reduce congestion or improve air quality, same type of thing. Again, you don't need to fill out every single one of these. You can fill out the ones that you are most opinionated on, or feel free to fill out all of them as well. Bike and pedestrian improvements, transit service, intelligent transportation systems, climate adaptation, climate mitigation. So the last little set of questions here, these are all optional. If you wanted to provide your name, an email, even your age, just to better understand some demographic information. Again, all optional, not necessary to complete the survey. And then preferred language if you want to share that information as well. Some race and origin questions, ethnicity, household income. And then another final box to kind of just provide any other feedback at all that you have on the RTP or transportation on Cape Cod. Once you've completed the survey, you will hit submit. You'll get this thanks for completing the survey, and it will also provide you a link to the online mapping tool if you'd like to fill that out. So this is the online mapping tool. Gives you sort of a welcome splash screen here. You can just select continue. This is a very similar sort of online mapping tool to the commission. We've done this with a lot of our complete streets projects over the last couple of years. And this is a really good way for folks to provide feedback at particular locations that they feel very strongly about. So there's some instructions over here on the left, but I can sort of do a live demo quickly. I did one earlier today in our meeting. There's an edit button right here at the bottom. What you can do is select that, and it offers you five categories of projects, bike, pedestrian, transit vehicle, or other. For this sake, I'll do bicycle. That's the one right at the top. So let's say that you want to, for an example here, extend the Cape Cod Rail Trail from Wellfleet to Provincetown, right? I would put this somewhere between Provincetown and Wellfleet. For now, I'll put it out here in the bay. And it now populates on the left here some more information you could fill out. So for that example, I'm going to say the location is Wellfleet to Provincetown. The description of the issue is lack of bike infrastructure. And then the comment we're providing is build a bike path. That's good enough for me right this second. At the bottom here, you would hit create, or well, there's one more tab, pardon me. Some of these are sort of washed out. We don't necessarily need to know the town. If you're placing a point on the map, we kind of know where that is, and you can provide the location for us. Under solution here, you can actually come in and choose, in this example would be multi-use path. You would hit create. So a quick refresh of the mapping tool here. It'll work quicker when you're not sharing your screen, I promise. Brings us back in. This is the point I just created for our example. And then you can select on that, and it provides all the information on the map that you filled out. So that way other folks can see the comments that you're providing. Staff can see the comments you're providing, and hopefully at the end of our comment period, this map is flooded with points of all different types of projects and ideas and suggestions for our region. So that's sort of my live demo. Colleen, I don't know if you wanted to add anything here. Or...
No, thank you, Dave. So this is the end of our presentation. So we are have time to just have a conversation, and we appreciate you attending. If there's an opportunity, to take our survey and to come back and revisit this, as always, we can put up our email addresses or the website as well. We're available for discussion, and we are meeting monthly with the Cape Cod MPO in March, April, May. So this will be continuing to be discussed, and again, we'll be back in the public. Scheduling public meetings for the late May, early June timeframe to present the final encompassing summary and document that is out for public comment before it is potentially approved by the MPO. But generally, please let us know. This is a time for us to help shape the vision. If there's any particular projects or strategies you would like to see implemented in the future. We're open to hear feedback. And if not, this is a website link to the RTP. So encourage you to go visit this at some point and provide your feedback on the survey. Again, this will be great to really see, try to for us to understand the needs of our traveling public, residents, visitors as well. So if you don't have any comments at this time, there's still plenty of time. Again, this RTP will not be approved or potentially approved until June timeframe. So there's still plenty of time for conversations. And again, this meeting will be recorded and we'll be posting it later on the website too. So if anyone missed the meeting, was not able to attend, they'll be up for later viewing. And I don't see any more comments or hands. So I'll do one last call tonight. If anyone would like to speak up, we really, really appreciate you coming to listen as well. Happy to hear any feedback at any point. Okay. Well, I appreciate you all for coming tonight. We're ending right before 7 o'clock, 1 hour. And we'll be stopping the recording. And I appreciate you for all attending today for the Cape Cod Regional Transportation Plan. And please take our survey.